For me, the best thing about Creative Computing Institute is the sense of community that we're creating. This is one of the few places in the world where you can see things from an arts perspective and also a science and technology perspective at the same time. And that means that together everyone is talking about something they can't really talk about anywhere else.
I studied at University of Arts London. I was like the techie person in like traditional design environments where maybe some of the things I needed or the spaces, the conversations I wanted to have did not exist. So when I knew that the CCI was being created, I was always trying to find ways on how I can get involved.
This is the first cohort of students in the program. I've been really impressed at how much they've taken the materials we've given them and made them their own.
Every time I come in the building, the students are just like chomping at the bit to show their work to people. I think it'll be a very, very good career for them.
So I'm showing my first project on the diploma. I thought it would be interesting to explore what if we could see in sound rather than light.
So I did the week-long machine learning course and the P5.js course with the CCI, and it's really helped me sort of develop my practice and teach me more of the development side of coding.
It's really changed my mind about like what computation is, what it means to the world, what it means like to society at large. Like, in the course of a year, I've like really changed how I'm thinking about it.
We have a beautiful mission and a great social agenda, and we really want to positively impact the way tech works in society.
I think of computing as a craft exercise, like pottery or weaving. It's going to take you a long time to become a master of it, but the first steps should be approachable by anyone. And I think that's an important part of what we do here at CCI.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this open day session at the Creative Computing Institute. My name is Georgina Cadovilla, and I am the Creative Learning Producer at CCI. And we're here today to talk about the Diploma in Creative Computing, both for second year students at UAL and those who are interested in taking the Graduate Diploma in Creative Computing. So today we've got with us Joel Gethin-Lewis, who's the head tutor at the Diploma. We will also hear from Vali Laliotti, who is the program director at CCI. And we also have with us Laiqa Mohid, who undertook the Diploma year last year, and William Brooks, who's a current student at the Diploma. So to give you a bit of an overview of how the session is structured today, we're going to talk a little bit about the CCI first. So talk about the spaces, the facilities and resources that are available to CCI students. Then we will hear from Vali about how the course is structured and the units of the year in creative computing. Then we will hear from Joel about a little bit more detail about the approach of the diploma and some of the amazing things that we've had the chance to do in this last year. And then we will have a chat with the students, with Laiqa and William, to hear a bit more about their experience. In terms of accessibility, Blackboard Collaborate doesn't display live captions, so if you have any difficulties following in along the session, just know that this session is being recorded and a recording of this session will be sent to you. So don't worry if you miss any detail in the meantime. So yes, just another note to say that there's a Q&A section at the end, so please feel free to send any questions or doubts that you have, and we'll do our best to cover it at the end during the Q&A bit. So let's get this started. I'm going to play now a video which tells you a little bit more about the CCI. Hope you enjoy it, and we'll see you in a second. Hi, everyone. In this video, we're going to show you around the campus and share some of the facilities and resources available to CCI students. The Creative Computing Institute is located at UAL's Peckham Road campus in Camberwell, South East London. The local area is home to a thriving art scene, which hosts a variety of art galleries and artist studios that students, graduates, and staff work and exhibit in. On site, there are two galleries, Camberwell Space and the Student Union Gallery, with the South London Gallery right next door and Peckham Platform in the local area. Also, on site, we have an amazing library supported by a dedicated CCI librarian, who oversees the subject area of creative computing ensuring the library stays up to date with the books, periodicals, databases, and other resources you need to complete your studies. The CCI is located across the 4th and 5th floor of the newest building at Peckham Road, which means it's very accessible to students with various needs. Let's take a look around. The CCI is divided into four main areas. At the heart of the space is the kitchen. At lunchtime, it becomes a social hub of CCI for folks to share lunch together, and during classes, it's quite a working space. Along the side are three classrooms, two seminar rooms, and one high-end computer suite fitted with some of the latest technology, including 24 high-spec computers with NVIDIA RTX 2080 graphics cards and 4K monitors for working on projects ranging from machine learning to 3D rendering and video editing. Additionally, many of these computers can actually be accessed remotely from home after hours to enable access to specialist software or the high performance for rendering or machine learning work. In addition to the computing facilities, we have dedicated spaces set up for electronics, soldering, 3D printing, and virtual reality facilities. Elsewhere within the building, CCI students have access to the 3D workshop, which includes additional 3D printing facilities, laser cutting, CNC machining, and a full wood workshop. We take COVID-19 safety very seriously, so at the moment our spaces are reconfigured to enable students to spread out 2 meters apart. There's also loads of windows to ensure good ventilation and hand and surface sanitizer throughout the space to keep things clean, on top of regular visits from cleaning staff. In normal times, we also operate a laptop locker system where students can borrow a laptop to use within the CCI spaces. This is just a glimpse of the amazing resources and facilities that are going to be available for you while studying at CCI. Now, I would like to briefly talk about the CCI social mission and public program. At CCI, we aim to integrate computational thinking with approaches to fairness and equality for the UAL and wider community. This is formally codified through our social mission, which focuses on diversity in technology, digital inclusion, and entrepreneurship. Our public program is underpinned by this mission and connects students, practitioners, and researchers with an international community of creative computing professionals. The aim of the public program is to offer a platform where UAL students, staff, and industry people can explore creative technology through workshops, public events, intensive courses, and fellowships awarded to practitioners in the field. To give you a sense of what you'll have the chance to take part in while studying at CCI, here are some of the programs that we've run. CCI's inaugural fellowship in 2018 was awarded to Feminist Internet. We run a series of workshops exploring the idea of a feminist Alexa. Our second fellowship was awarded to creativeapplications.net, in which we delved into creative coding with custom LED displays and innovative ways to apply new technologies. CCI awarded its third fellowship to artist and researcher Anna Riddler. Together, we ran a learning program called Artificial AI, where we explored some of the problematics embedded in datasets. In parallel, we've run several week-long intensive courses open to all UAL students, which included inclusive design in wearable technology, designing a feminist chatbot, computational thinking with P5.js, machine learning for the creative industries, design with data and interactive machine learning, and the latest one we run, querying voice AI transcendental design. We also started the CCI After School Club, now renamed Tech Yard, a safe space aimed at young people, families, and beginners based in the local area in Peckham and Camberwell, who want to learn creative computing in a supportive environment. This is just a quick overview of all the opportunities that we've been able to provide to UAL and CCI students over the last 2 years. But there are so many exciting things that are on the way and that we cannot wait for you to take part in. Thanks so much for watching and listening. I hope you enjoyed what you just seen. And now let's keep moving. Hello again. I hope you found that useful. So now we're going to play a video that Vali Laliotti recorded for us, in which she shares some more important bits about the Diploma in Creative Computing. So I'm going to go ahead and play this one and see you in a second.
Hello. I'm Dr. Vali Laliotti. I'm the program director of the Creative Computing Institute. I'm also the acting course leader of the diploma degree. I'm delighted to welcome you today in our open day event about the diploma in creative computing. The Creative Computing Institute offers a variety of innovative courses and also research opportunities to explore how computer science and creative practice can come together. In this way, we are part of UAL that explores how technology is shaping our world, and it prepares you, the next generation of creative talent, to shape the world with technology. The diploma course is an opportunity for students from across the UAL, from all types of creative disciplines, to add a material understanding of computational technologies and to use those technologies within different practices. It's an understanding also of how this kind of technologies create innovation both in the creative industries but also in art and design. It is also a great opportunity to network and work together with talent from across UAL and across many disciplines from art and design and performances. I'd like to show you this slide, which is a course overview. I'm only going to briefly talk about this because Joel will go in a lot more detail about what each unit looks like and what exciting things you're going to be learning and how. It's important just to show you this so that you understand the kind of structure that we follow. So we have a similar structure to other UAL courses with two blocks. And in the first block that spans across the first term and part of the spring term, you have three units with 20 credits for each unit. We have the first unit teaching you coding and the fundamental computing frameworks. Then the next unit is about artificial intelligence, and that builds both on coding artificial intelligence. Is not that hard. It's quite exciting to be able to do that because also it allows us to talk more academically and in terms of the impact on society. And then in the final part, you're going to be learning physical computing and also integrate your learning into your creative practice. It is the same rhythm that we will use in block two. So we will have you building up on your coding with looking at app development and learning that. And we will connect also your learning to what is happening outside in the industry. So we will have, if COVID allows, visits to creative practices and also guest speakers to talk a little bit more about how they use creative technologies in different disciplines. And finally, we will have more project-led work where you consolidate the two terms into a creative practice around computational environments. So this way, we allow you to learn and then also practice in a very similar way to what a creative studio will do. And similar to what you used also in your current courses. In terms of assessment, because that's always a question, we also have different types of assessment so that it fits different styles of learning. For example, in the more coding units, we will have some tests around coding. So you might be answering multiple choice questions or you might be writing a piece of code. And that is one part of assessing. Another part of assessing, for example, in artificial intelligence, would be reading academic papers and journals and writing an essay around your thinking and of artificial intelligence. And finally, you have the more creative practice modules and units where you could do mini projects, and you can be tested around those. I hope you are excited about this. Joel will just go into a lot more detail on what you will be doing in every unit. And also we have alumni and students. So in the Q&A session, we're going to interview them and you can ask questions of me, Joel, and our students and alumni. Thank you.
Hello again. Sending you a huge thank you to Vali for putting this video together. Unfortunately, she cannot be here with us today, but now I'm going to introduce Joel, who will, as Vali mentioned, go into a lot more detail into the units and approach of the diploma. So yes, Joel, over to you.
Thanks, Georgina. Hello, everyone. I'm Joel Gethin-Lewis, the head tutor lecturer on the Diploma in Creative Computing here at the CCI. I'm going to share with you, first of all, a little bit more detail about the course structure. So I'm going to show that to you here on that one. Hopefully you lot should be able to see that screen. Is that coming through? Is that, I can think it's coming through. I can see it. This is excellent. This is excellent progress. Great. So this is the website with a whole bunch of information about the diploma. I'm putting that in the chat right now if anyone wants to take a look at that themselves on their own internet browsing device of their choice. Here's some more information about the course. So first of all, it's clear, just to make it clear to everyone, that the diploma, the undergraduate diploma, is designed for someone who's already at the doing a BA in some subject at UAL. And then what happens at the end of it, if you do the diploma, is you do an extra year with us. We inject you with a load of creative computing knowledge, and then you go back to your course for your final third year. And then you'll get your degree in whatever it was, but with creative computing. So the reason that I was so keen to teach on the diploma was because it was all around, based around a course where we've got a whole group of really interesting students from all over UAL that already have existing practices. And that's the thing that I'm most excited about, because in a way, I'm most excited about the possibility of creative computing to become standard part of anyone's study in the idea in the areas of design or artistic practice. And I think that's the way things are going to go, right? It's going to stop being a specialized thing, and it's going to be something that just happens in every single subject. You know, as Mark Anderson said apocryphally at the end of the 90s, software is going to eat the world, and I believe it will do that. Vali hinted a little bit at the kind of structure of the course, starting off with these three units in the first block and then another three units in the second block. I'm the lecturer for units one and four, which is where you'll get your main kind of computer science and computing knowledge. The first unit, unit one, creative coding and creative computing frameworks, is going to give you a solid grounding in a pair of computing frameworks, most likely JavaScript and Open Frameworks. The framework will be P5.js for JavaScript. Open Frameworks uses C++ as its main language. And then Unit 2 is all about computational futures and artificial intelligence. That's with Rebecca and Alex Fafega. The pair of them will take you through a lot of the kind of critical thinking around computational futures and artificial intelligence before Unit 3, which is much more about physical computing. And Indra has been taking that course this year with Alice Stewart. The course structure is then kind of mirrored in the second block, where you get another block of computer science knowledge from me in Unit 4. And that's centered much more about kind of making apps, so mobile apps, either for Android or iOS. And then Unit 5, again taken by Alex with help from Rebecca, is going to be all about work in the creative digital industry. So that's about establishing your practice, visiting a lot of other studios, seeing how other people do things differently, what their mix in their careers are, whether it's commercial, academic, artistic-based, research-based, whatever it is, kind of trying to get as much of a kind of impression of different people's practices and kind of life patterns, before finishing up with Unit 6, which is all about computational environments. Now, if Unit 3 was about physical computing, Unit 6 is all about bringing that physical computing out into the larger world. So networked environments, projection mapping, lighting, responding to inputs in real time. The assessment methods are split across these three areas as well. So we've got exams, either multiple choice tests or kind of practical exams, coursework in terms of essays and presentations, and then formal projects for Unit 6 and Unit 3. So hopefully that's given you a bit of an impression of the course from the official course website. How am I doing on time? Because last time I did an open day, I came in almost exactly on time, which I'm very excited about. I think I have up to 14:28, so I have 8 more minutes to go. This makes me very excited. Okay, now I can see Georgina nodding at me. This is a good sign. I'm going to show you now the GitHub link for the breakdown of Unit 1 itself. This is the GitHub for it. I will share the notes here for you as well. So this is the current year's Unit 1 notes. So this is all hosted up on GitHub. I'm completely open source with all of my teaching. You can always go back there and have a look at the lecture notes and the slides as well. So there's some breakdown here in terms of term dates and things like that, dealing with the rotation of in-person teaching because of this godforsaken plague that we find ourselves in. A code of conduct, a kind of repeating of the block term structure. So just for any of you who aren't aware, blocks span multiple terms. So we've got 3 terms in a year. Block 1 goes into term 1, the autumn term, and partially into the spring term. And then block 2 follows on immediately halfway into the spring term and then finishing up with the summer term. So block 1's got 3 units, block 2's got 3 units, and they each are broken up into these areas of Unit 1 being more creative coding, Unit 2 being thinking critically about computational futures and artificial intelligence, Unit 3 being about physical computing, and then Block 2, same pattern again, me teaching you how to make apps this time, Alex teaching you about the kind of variety of practices that are out there in the digital creative industries, and then Indra Knight following up with Alice Stewart in Unit 6 to think about how we bring computing into kind of multi-user environments. Any of you UAL already should already be familiar with these standard 5 learning outcomes of inquiry, knowledge, process, and communication. Let's get a bit more into the detail now of Unit 1, Block 1. In this unit, I teach both JavaScript and C++ and the libraries P5JS and Open Frameworks within that, with some use of these different tools as well as Slack, P5JS Editor, and GitHub. I teach with a flipped classroom style, so that means that we're going to spend as much time in person going through problems, and then the lectures are pre-recorded outside of hours. You can play them back at your will. The assessment is via a multiple choice test and a practical exam. I'll send you the link for that. So if you want to have a look at the kind of level of exam challenge, you can have a look at last year's exams there now. I promise you that the amount of progress you will make in this course will astound you. The students for this year's diploma have only been on with us for, I think, a month and a half now, and they already cannot believe how far they've come in those 6 weeks. It is extraordinary, some of the kind of creative outputs that have been happening through the term already. There's a whole series of exercises that I do as well. These are all based around this upcoming book from Golan Levin and Tager Brain. Code as a Creative Medium. Can't wait for that one to come out. We're lucky enough to have got a pre-press copy of that, and that's what I've been doing some of the exercises around. Then we've got the rest of the schedule here. Okay, that's enough of kind of the overview. Let's get into a bit of detail of what Joel teaching you a unit of this is actually going to look like. So if I share my screen again, let me get this Chrome tab up, and I will be able to demonstrate to you some of the slides. So here we go. These are all the lectures and workshops from the year that the unit is running right now. I'll give you the chat link for those as well. And this is broken down into a series of lectures and workshops. As I said before, it's a flipped classroom, so you'll be watching your lectures at your ease. Here's the introduction lecture. I'm just going to zip through it very quickly in the remaining 4 minutes I have left. Oh no, I've got to show the show as well, haven't I, Georgina? Okay, I'll be very crisp with this, and then I'll show last year's show. So hi, I'm Joel. Welcome to the Creative Computing Institute. Welcome to the Diploma in Creative Computing. And actually, I'm going to inaugurate you all. You're all diplomats now. You're pre-diplomats. So the idea is that as you've done the diploma, you've become a diplomat. And the idea is that you're going to return to your course and be diplomats for the land of creative coding. A little bit about my background, just to give you some details of what I was doing before I went into this teaching practice. Born in London, grew up in Wales on a mountain, did a degree in computer science at Imperial and then a master's in interaction design at the Royal College of Art. I had a year at Fabrica upon graduation and then went to work for the extraordinary studio United Visual Artists, doing tours for bands like U2 and Massive Attack. Then I had 8 years of running my own studio with my best mate, Pete Helicar. That was all about the experiment of making an art, design and technology studio using open source software and giving away everything we made. That went on for 8 years, from 2008 to 2016. And then when that shut down in 2016, I went to lecture at the Central St. Martin's Narrative Environments course, as well as back to the Royal College of Art to lecture in visual communication. And then last real year, I became the head lecturer in the Diploma in Creative Computing. And I've also become the Interactive Creative Director at Universal Everything. My two interests in research areas are about solar powered mesh computing and making global scale augmented reality sculpture. Anyway, enough about me. What are the most important things to know about the CCI? Well, you can go through all of this. You can see these if you want. You can reference it all for yourself. But I think this is the most important thing. Where are we? I'm just zipping through these. Okay, this is the most important thing in coding and possibly the most important thing in your life, right? What is the thing that Dory does? What does Dory do? Anyone can type it into the chat if they've got an idea. Laiqa should know this and William should know this as well. I'm testing to see if they're even listening. They're probably not even listening. No, they are, I'm sure they are. They're just typing, just keep swimming. Yes, exactly. Laiqa, a billion points to Gryffindor. Okay, this is the most important thing about programming and your practice and your life in general. Okay, the most critical thing is to just keep swimming, right? Just keep going. And the thing that I'm trying to imbue you with, if you come and do the Diploma in Creative Computing with me and the rest of the lovely team, including Georgina here at CCI, is that I'm trying to make you resilient, right? I'm trying to give you the superpowers that you're going to need to work through some of the big problems that we've got as a whole planet here, but also to get you into a practice that is sustainable and works for you. So that's what I'm dedicated to. Okay, I've got 3 minutes left. I can't show you the rest of the lectures because there's far too much to go on there. There's all this amazing stuff about rubber ducks, why they're important. I'll tell you about that if you come on the course. What originality means, why you should stay in the game, lots of amazing JavaScript and other resources, some things to explode your brain. Have a look at all of these. These are some amazing lectures. I can't help myself. I'm going to put my link in the chat. Yes, please put questions in here now. There's a question from Constance there that Georgina might want to answer. And I'm just going to finish up by showing you all the show. Constance, maybe if you put your email address in, if you have to go, we'll get back to you. We'll get back to you after the presentation is over with your question. I'm just going into the Chrome tab now, and here is the show. So this is the show that we did last academic year, this summer. Of course, it had to be a socially distanced show. You can see it there. So we ended up having to make this kind of point and click adventure. I'm going to put my username in here, Joel. And that's my avatar. And now I can actually click walk around in this amazing reproduction of CCI at Camberwell. And we can have a look around, we can check out the map, we can go into various different areas. It's the animal room. Let's have a look at this. Let's try Boggle. Here is the project of Boggle. Let me link it over so you can actually see what happened there, because it popped up in another screen. Chrome tab, Boggle, share the audio. Here we go. So here's Boggle. And let's see what this is. I think we've got a real-time doggy crown going on. Oh, where am I? There we go. I have a head and face covered with dogs. Who could not want that? I'm going to stop there because I've taken up enough time already, and we're coming up to some important parts, which is some testimony from current and previous students. So I'm going to stop talking now. Thank you very much for your attention, and I will hand you back to Georgina. Georgina, over to you.
Thanks, Joel, for such a good presentation. Yeah, it was great to hear more about the course. Now, I would like to welcome William and Laiqa to join us in this virtual space. So we have around 15 minutes now to just have a chat with them and hear about their experience completing and undertaking the diploma in this current moment. So if you want to turn your cameras and audios on, we would love to hear from you. Hey, William.
Hey, William.
Hey, is my...
Hey, Laiqa.
Is my camera...
Hey, Laiqa, we hear you. Your camera isn't on, but we can hear you.
We can hear you well.
All right.
Yes. Amazing. So yeah, how are you getting on, William? Let's start with you. How is it for you this year, undertaking the diploma, being part of CCI, coming to our campus? How it's going for you?
Well, I'm thoroughly enjoying it, despite the bizarre times of COVID. It's certainly new, engaging in a blended learning style, which I'm not sure if you guys will be, you know, doing next year, because hopefully COVID isn't as bad. I mean, we'll see with the vaccines and whatnot. But I'm thoroughly enjoying it, especially I was previously on the BA Photography at Camberwell, so I'm familiar with the campus. And I also participated in Anna Riddler's workshop. Goodness me, when was that? Last autumn, perhaps? I think it carried through until the beginning of this year. And I had I had a few ideas that I wanted to kind of realize, and I was kind of at the limit of my knowledge when it came to physical computing. So I thought about signing up to this course, and I'm glad I did. it's been brilliant. It's been a great opportunity to network with all sorts of people from different backgrounds with different practices. I've thoroughly been enjoying it.
Amazing. And how do you see your creative practice being shaped now that you are part of this CCI family and learning so many new skills? How are you blending, you know, your own creative practice and all this new skill set that you're learning at the moment?
Yeah, I mean, I think when I was on my previous course, I was kind of trying to pick up all sorts of different things and trying to inspire myself. I think one thing Joel instills in you within the first term is this idea of being an autodidactic person, which is kind of this self-taught, which is, I guess, the same as just being inquisitive anyway. And I've been, when I signed up to this course, it was something that I immediately felt, and it was great to be part of a network and a community of similar like-minded people. This idea of not being afraid of picking up new skills and new languages, which should promote new perspectives, I guess.
Yeah, completely. That's what the diploma is about. So yeah, good to hear that's how you're experiencing it. Cool. What about you, Laiqa? What course are you, like, did you go back to this year after completing the diploma?
I went back to graphic design to finish my final year. It was amazing because I actually wasn't going to do the diploma year, and I'd missed the email chains for it. And one of my friends just told me, like, oh, Joel's teaching it. And I was like, what? And then I immediately emailed you. Go in there. But it was such an experience. Like, it's just a real test of, I guess, your resilience in learning and, like, keep getting back up after, like, falling constantly. It's quite an intense year, so you have to be ready to, like, go back to school and get your notes out and take notes and stuff. So I think the main point is, like, just being ready to, like, be a sponge, just absorb information for that whole year, and then you have enough time to experiment on your own after you get out of the diploma as well, because you'll have the tools.
Yeah, I have to admit, I do put a lot of, I put a lot of content in there, as you can see from that lecture zero. I definitely put in, you know, a surfeit of content, but I think the point that William brought up there and Laiqa spoke about as well is this idea of, like, autodidactism, right? Which is, an autodidact is someone who's able to teach themselves, and that's not just me being lazy in my teaching. It's also that I want to get you lot into a position where if there's anything that you ever want to find out about in your future, you're confident enough to be able to find that stuff yourself. And I think that's something that goes kind of beyond UAL beyond university, everything. My aim is to turn people out that can come up with things that want to challenge themselves in a sustainable way, but make it happen as well. But I wanted to ask, actually, Laiqa, if you could have traveled back in time to yourself when you were about to start the diploma, what would you tell yourself?
Okay. So I think what I would do is to not aim too high immediately with my projects, because you are just learning these things. It's more like get your foundations together and make anything you can with the material you learned, instead of like having some crazy briefs that, you know, they did teach me many things though, I have to say, during the project, but I would still say like dial it down, make it simple, make projects that will teach you about things you want to learn about more than anything else you know going on. And I also think like spending the extra amount of time working through a lot of the exercises you give was really helpful in a way that just doing the basic, like the way your mind thinks is different to how you would when you're using Illustrator or like a tool like that, because there's a lot of planning that goes into code, and then there's a lot of experimentation while coding as well. So it's all like a combined process of all of these different disciplines. But yeah, that's what I'd say.
Which college were you at? LCC or CSM? I can't remember.
I'm at CSM now. Yeah.
CSM. Okay.
Cool. Yeah. I'm still coding. Amazing. I haven't stopped since.
Yay!
So that's
great. That's what I want to hear.
Yeah, it's cool. I've stopped using P5 as much, even though I love it, but I'm trying to fly.
Like, that's amazing.
The bubble, yeah.
Yeah, you talked about experimentation, and I think that is like one of the most precious things about the diploma, is that it brings together people from across UAL, and everyone has their own creative practice, and they come together to learn creative computing, and then they all go back to their course and apply it in so many different ways. So what it's been your experience like going back to your course and just having all this new skill set, and you know, like what was it like to be part of that sort of environment and then going back to your course?
It's almost like before I started the course, I was a printmaker, so I was extremely hands-on, and I would like be screen printing and stuff. It was very different, and then coming back into this, it kind of is like, you know, there had to be a way to combine that old analog method of doing and then this way of doing. So I guess like in a way it was more about integrating like why I liked tactile things and how do I combine that into the digital world, and that was really helpful because like it helped fuel my dissertation and how I'm gonna write down, you know, some subjects talking about that. But I think overall in terms of knowledge, like that's the main thing that has affected my practice now in terms of the interaction and what that, you know, holds different technologies in like interaction, like haptic sensors or stuff like that, that kind of helped me write my dissertation now.
That's amazing. And what it's like for you, William, being part of this environment, because I think this year's cohort is a quite diverse one in terms of backgrounds as well. So how are you finding it?
Yeah, I think it's been brilliant. I think thinking back on it, I wouldn't have had an opportunity to experience students from other courses anyway. If I was on photography, it's kind of just photography students all the way, and sometimes that can have this kind of a hive mentality in terms of a working practice, which is kind of counterintuitive really. So having this really quite large depth of different backgrounds and different practices is, you know, it's been fantastic. And yeah, I can only see it as a major positive to push in my own practice. To the students in the session, it is a fantastic opportunity to see in terms of meeting new people, new faces, and exposing yourself to new perspectives.
That's amazing. Thanks, William. Yeah, please, everyone in the room, if you have any questions or you would like to
give us your questions. I want like questions. William, I'm hungry. I'm hungry for questions. Feed me questions. I'm going to start calling names out and embarrassing people directly. This is going to be fun. So Constance has already interacted. That's fine. Ewan, James, Lauren, Luke, Mazzano. We had a little chat with Mazzano in the behind the scenes section. Min, Rosemary, Vlad. Okay, this is good. Here we go. Okay.
So interview process, work, and application process. So I can cover that myself. So there's no interview attached to this application process. The way that students apply is very simple. It's only through a form. So we are finalizing now the process of putting together that form. And I believe it will go out in a few days, if not maybe in a week, the latest. So it's going to be an online form that you complete. You just tell us a little bit about what you're interested in and why you want to take part in the diploma. And then we go through a selection process and we just make offers to students. But that is, of course, if you are a second-year student at UAL. If you want to take the graduate diploma, you should go through UCAS, and then you just go to the website. I'm just going to paste the links to the course pages on the chat now. And then you just follow the application system at UCAS, and then you just put together your application. But it's a very straightforward form. There's no interview needed for the process. And, yeah, just a little bit telling – just hearing about your interest and your practice, submitting some of the work you've done so far, if you have a portfolio, and that's all really. It's a super straightforward process. Okay, we have another question from James.
Do we
want to add something on that?
I'll take it. How does the learning work? Do we learn coding from the ground up? If we always have a background in CERTs, will the first parts of the course be repetition? Okay, so Rosemary, I'll get to your question after I've answered James's one. So as Vali said in the video, we kind of do three different kinds. There's three different kinds of assessment and three different kinds of learning that goes with that. I probably do the most traditional learning in terms of computer science knowledge, where I'm lecturing you and you're doing exercises and working through things in that way. In unit two with Alex and Rebecca, where you're being more critical and thinking about machine learning and its applications and its pitfalls in the future, as William and Laiqa will testify to, it's much more about working towards to a letter, an essay, right? So you're much more developing your critical writing skills. And then the final unit, which is with Indra and Alice, thinking about physical computing, that's much more in a kind of practical hands-on, we'll give you an electronics kit and you'll be putting circuits together at home. So if you do have programming experience already, I'd say that my unit is probably gonna be a bit of revision. That's no bad thing. You may not have encountered JavaScript before. You may not have encountered the library that we use, T5JS, before. So that'll definitely be useful for it. And I'd say that then those other courses, the physical computing, if you haven't encountered that, of course, that's going to be brand new. And also this idea of critical academic writing as well, that will be brand new. So I'd say if you do have programming experience, great. I think if you do have a strength in coding, you're probably going to have you might have some other areas that you might want to, you know, level up a little bit more. And we're certainly flexible in terms of that. I think William and Laiqa will both be able to attest is that there's such a variety of learning going on in the diploma. There's inevitably some things you're going to be stronger at, and there's going to be some things that you're going to want to improve. And that happens in everyone. And one of the things for everyone, and one of the things that I'm most keen to do is actually get a community going between the students, right? So my aim is always to make myself irrelevant as possible, right? So if I can get a community of learners working together, then I know that you'll accelerate away from me, and that would be the thing that would make me the happiest. So hopefully that answers your question, James. Rosemary Sutano, how much coding would you expect to see in the portfolio of someone coming from a fairly different degree? I'm dabbling in JS for the context of XR, but I can't say I'm that great yet working on it though. That's great that you're working on it and that you're aware of it. I presume you are thinking, Rosemary, about applying to the graduate diploma. So that's a level up in terms of attainment, because it's a postgraduate qualification. But the interview process and the process for going in, of course, you have to go through UCAS, as Georgina already said. But in terms of what we're doing, we really see the diploma, both the undergraduate and the graduate diploma, as a stepping stone, right? To more integration with creative computing. So if you've got some experience of coding, that's great. If you haven't, no problem. The thing that I always look for in portfolios or when I'm collaborating with anyone, whether it's at UAL or in my professional practice at Universal, everything, is I just want to see people who are nerds. I want to see people who are obsessed about stuff. I want to see people who are passionate about it. I don't care what you're passionate about. I just want to see that you're passionate about it. That's the most important thing that I'm looking for, right? I can pass on and communicate my creative coding knowledge to you, but if you're not engaged, there's nothing I can do. So I want to see engagement. That's the thing that I'm most excited about. Constance, when is the application deadline? Are places offered before this? Georgina, do you want to take that one?
I'll cover that. Yes. Yeah, sorry I missed this bit of information before. So we're gonna run two rounds of applications. The first one will end at the end of term one. So that will be around the 26th of March. And then we're gonna review all the applications and offer places to the students that applied in the next like 2 weeks. So I guess that would be around mid-April. And then we're gonna have the second round of applications for the late applicants, and that will be around first week of June. So that will give other students the chance to apply again, and then offers will be made in the next two few weeks as well. Ideally, we would just finish all the confirmation process and application process with students around mid-June, because of course how the system needs to be set up for the next academic year. So that is an overview of the date, but of course everything will be specified on the form, so you can just check that when it's live, and all the dates will be there listed. So yeah, I hope that answers your questions. Let me know otherwise. Okay, cool.
Mazzano, does the CCI have access to Cinema 4D? We don't have official Cinema 4D teaching, but we do have access via Linda to all the tutorials that I think are available to anyone at UAL anyway. So you could always be doing that if you're already at UAL. We definitely have some Blender teaching going on. I think that's in the BSc and also in the MSc. One of the things that's exciting is that as the BSc and the MSc become more mature, because obviously it takes a few years for someone to complete a BSc, unlike the diploma, which is a 1 year short and sweet, that there's more integration now happening between those courses, right? So if you came to CCI to do the diploma and you said, Joel, I'm really obsessed about 3D, I could totally connect you to other people doing the BSc, the MSc, or even PhD students to give you that level of knowledge. And that's really up to you in terms of pushing yourself to do that. Vlad says, did you answer that question already, Vlad? Georgina, about Vlad saying long do you have to
accept? Yeah, I covered it. Yeah.
Okay. And then I just like to highlight what Laiqa said there, right? Her highlight for herself is that when leaving the diploma, you're not abandoned, right? As I said that, once you're a diplomat, you're a diplomat for the kind of land of creative coding forever, even after you leave UAL and all that kind of thing. You know, I'm here to support you in your practice, and that doesn't finish until I die. Right. This is really what I want to do, is to help people help themselves become autodidactic and do things in a sustainable way. So as Laiqa said, you get access to the diploma Slack, which is where we do all our communications. You'll have access to that for the rest of your life. And that will be a great place for, as the kind of the alumni group gets larger and larger, I'm sure more and more opportunities are going to develop out of this. It's basically my pension scheme, is educating as many people as possible with creative coding, sending them out to the world, and then them offering me shares in their massive startups afterwards. And then this is my strategy. Okay, Vlad, what is the course look right now? How many days do students get on campus? So it's a blended learning model at the moment. We've actually just finished the blending learning model for this term now. So basically, we're echoing what the rest of UAL is doing. So as I understand it, UAL is now completely off campus to allow people to get tests and go back to their families for the holidays break if they'd like to. I understand some people are staying at halls. There's a whole mix of things going on. When it's not decided what's going to happen yet when we come back, we're still waiting for a kind of decision from the government and the wider university community and the wider UAL community in terms of what's going to happen there. We've been doing up until this point a blended learning system. So that means that basically every week students get two in-person sessions, a teaching session and a learning or exercise session. And we've been doing that in a 1 in 3 week cycle. So one out of every 3 weeks, you get to have a crazy day with me. And then one out of every 3 weeks, you get a crazy day with Alex and Rebecca. And then one out of every 3 weeks, you get a crazy day with Alice and Indra. So we're kind of cycling through that. And the reason for that is so that we can offer you in-person contact, which we realize is a really important part of the student experience, but at the same time, trying to make it safe for staff, as because that's obviously got to be a concern of ours, and we balance those two things. Hope that answers your question, Vlad. If anyone has any further questions about any of this outside of the session, you can just email the cci@arts.acuk account that Georgina's about to put up on the screen again now. We're psychically linked. I can tell when she's typing. And then Rosemary's question, does creative coding include both pieces of art assisted generated by code and using code to assist an overall project? Yes. Not a silly question at all, Rosemary. So question one, creative coding includes pieces of art generated by code and also using code to assist in an overall project. Yes. So you can have kind of pure, as it were, creative coding projects where it's completely related to the act of creative coding. Or the other way you can do it is kind of in a kind of craft way, as in you're using that creative code and digital knowledge to feed into your practice, which could be analog, it could be pottery, it could be weaving, it could be any of these other craft aspects. And I think I see coding as a craft in itself. Some of the things I'll be teaching you about include the history of computing. And in that, you'll see that via the Jacquard loom, the beginning of all computing is actually textiles. So there you go. Does 3JS count as creative coding? Yes, it totally does. And it's not a silly question. Ha ha ha. Not at all. Vlad, would you help out with other languages that live outside the learning units, maybe like Python? Yes. That is going to be on a project by project basis though, Vlad. But if you come to me with a passion and say, Joel, I just really want to get into machine learning in Python, either I or another member of the faculty or someone else in the wider creative computing community, I will connect you to that person and make that happen. But referring back to what William said right at the beginning of this about trying to encourage autodidactic behavior, autodidactic is just a silly technical word for self-teaching, right? What I want you to get into a position is where you could go, Joel, I'm interested in this, and I give you the tools to enable you to learn whatever you want to.
Hmm.
Totally welcome, Vlad.
Amazing.
Have you got any examples of what guests come in and talk? Yes, we have. If you take a look at the YouTube channel for CCI, there's a bunch of the talks up there now already. That's a program that's continuing. Alex Fafega did a whole bunch of amazing talks for Unit 2 last academic year. They're about to start again next term. Alex is already getting up an incredible list of people. So yeah, take a look at the YouTube channel. It's just been posted up by Georgina there. So youtube.com/UAL-CCI. Have a look at that. There's an example there of creative talks, some of the research talks, some of the amazing after school sessions we've been doing as well, which is probably a really good way of getting an intro to creative coding if you're nervous about that. There's some of the work from Anna Riddler, who was our resident at the Creative Computing Institute. She's got an amazing practice about artificial intelligence and machine learning and being critical of that, as well as buying lots of tulips and doing other fantastic things. So take a look at that. And I think, if I'm not wrong, there's also some of the more research orientated stuff. So I think Nick Grierson's put up some videos there as well. I know Phoenix Perry has as well. And there's on top of that as well, there's some really interesting hires that are about to happen that we can't talk about yet. But basically, CCI is a growing family. Come and be part of it. We'd love to have you here. And how many people are on the course? So if the lectures are up on YouTube, what's the incentive of jumping on the course? The lectures aren't up on YouTube. They're up on Moodle. So you have to do it via Moodle. But also the incentive of the course is you get to experience Joel in real life. You get the extraordinary physical reality of that. And most of all, actually, the most important part of the course isn't the staff. It's not the building. It's the students. And that's the real reason that I'm sure Laiqa and William will echo as well. The point of it is, it's not really about us. It's about you. It's about you and the relationships that you make as part of the UAL Diploma and then the CCI and then the UAL families, and how you continue with those in your practice. So yeah, sure. There's millions of amazing resources online to go on YouTube and other places to learn about creative coding if that's what you want to do. But the thing that's most exciting to me is the community of like-minded readers, researchers, and activists and thinkers all being together in the same place. And that's kind of the killer app. That's the reason for universities in the first place, right? You could just go off to the library and read up yourself on whichever subject you wanted to do. But the thing that's really exciting about it is being able to link up with other practitioners, other peers, other excited, motivated people, and, you know, invent the future. James, how many people on the course? So it was around, I think we were around 30 in the first academic year, which is the one that Laiqa was in. And now we're up to 60, I think, this year. And then we could grow up. Vlad, in essence, you join a cool club for a year and then you get lifetime membership of that cool club. So it's even cooler. you're already part of the cool club by being on this chat. So, you know, if you like this little slice of seeing how Georgina and I and Laiqa and William talked about their practice and the results that have come out of it, if you liked it, come and join in. The world is lovely.
Like,
it's going to be a fantastic third year.
I have to add, like,
yes.
If you're going into the course, like, you have to understand that it's everything self-taught. Basically, you are spending hours learning things by yourself because you have to in the beginning as well, but also because what you're getting with the taught sessions is what to look for and how to look for it. So if you know that, even after leaving the course, you'll be able to do whatever you need to do because you have these, like, really core technical terms that, you know, under your belt that you can Google, and you can get to different complex projects just by yourself. Even you won't need really any sort of language being taught at, like, clearly and technically. But yeah.
Woo! I did not pay Laiqa to say that. She said that entirely of her own choice.
We can talk about payment later, but yeah.
I think the point of it is really true though. Like, I'm gonna give you a bunch of superpowers during this year that you can then use for whatever you want to after that. And what Laiqa says is true. Of course, you have to have some self-discipline when you're learning anything new, whether it's a computer language or a human language, right? If you want to learn a human language that you don't know already, of course you could just read about it in books, but the best way of learning it is to go to that country and immerse yourself in it. So, you know, it's like we've made CCI Island here. You can come and immerse yourself in it and then go out into the world speaking these amazing new digital languages. But also, I think the thing that's really important is if you look at the world we're in now, it's really important that people from lots of different backgrounds, not just computer science, classic engineering backgrounds, go into this digital world. Because I think we wouldn't have a lot of the problems that we're seeing now with toxicity on digital networks if we had people from a wider variety of backgrounds engaging in this work. So please come and visit the CCI Island. I'm going to call it, yeah, it's the Creative Computing Island. It's not the Institute anymore, it's the island. It's perfect.
Love that. Thanks, Joel, and thanks, Laiqa and William, to be here and join us and share some of your experience. I think we made it to the end of the session, so I'll encourage anyone who has further questions about the diploma or about the CCI to reach us out on our email. So we'll be there to sort out whatever doubt you have. And yes, in the meantime, we're going to be running a few other sessions this week. We also have the MSc in Creative Computing Graduate Showcase coming up on Thursday. So if you want to get to know a bit more about what we're developing at the CCI, what students are developing, come and join us into this online virtual show because it's going to be a really cool one. It's going to be run across the evenings of Thursday and Friday from 6 p.m. So yes, thanks everyone for joining us online today. We look forward to receiving your applications, to receiving your questions, whatever comes our way. And yes, thanks everyone. We hope to meet you.
Thank you, Ewan, Jane, Lauren, Luke, Mazzano, Rosemary, Vlad, everyone. Live long and prosper.
Thanks everyone. Bye bye.